I'm Bob Mendonja, and this is Julie, and we have two children, Emily, who is in college in California, and our son, Will, who's 17. He's back in Kenya.
Hi, this is Danny Broughton. I'm the Denison pastor of the Cottonwood Creek campus in Denison. This is my wife, Sarah, of 21 years. We have five children.
Hey guys, my name is Javier Perez, and I work for Bucking Missions here in the Rio Grande Valley. I'm married to Aura, who's 27. We have a beautiful daughter, who's 4, Shanti Perez.
Good morning, Cottonwood Creek. My name is Jeff Belcher. I am the pastor of Church of the Harbor in Baltimore, Maryland. My family and I moved here in November of 2014.
Hey, Cottonwood Creek. My name is Jonathan Land, pastor and church planter of Connection Church in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Married 11 years now to Shelby, and we have two beautiful girls.
Hi, hello. My name is Joshua. I'm the third son of a family of five. Mom and Dad, they work in DR as pastors in Puerto Plata.
Hi, I'm Ryan. This is my wife, Melinda, and we're the Williams.
We have four children. Our oldest, Carter, is 10 years old. And then we have three girls. Cammy is 6, Alexa is 4, and we have a new baby who is 8 months old.
Hey, my name is Trey Talley. I'm the pastor of the church at Pecan Creek in South Denton / Corinth. I've been married to a wonderful young lady, my wife, Felicia Talley, for many years now. We have four children. Three of them are still at home, and one is off to college.
So the Lord prompted us to go to Kenya for the first time in 2003 as a family. And we began going on trips. After our fourth trip, we began to feel the power of a greater affection to move to Kenya. And so in 2008, we moved there, and I began working for Cure International as an orthopedic surgeon there. And we also started a children's home called Naomi's Village.
Our ministry at Cottonwood Creek Denison campus is helping support, revitalize a church that was very numerically and financially anemic. And with the help of Cottonwood Creek, that campus is thriving. We're able to minister to a community that needs the gospel presented there, but also the help of family support.
When we visited Baltimore, we just got a picture of the lostness, and we just felt compelled to pursue more of an evangelistic teaching ministry. So in January of 2014, Kelly and I committed to moving forward and planting a church.
And while everyone was asking questions like, are there churches in this city? The better question for us was, are there lost people in this city? God began to open doors for us to plant in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, to where now we're helping plant a church, the fourth in 5 years, and have seen God just be so amazingly generous in the way that we've been fruitful in our ministry.
We went to Puerto Plata because my parents had the calling from the Lord. God sent us there for three months to deliver a message to the people of Puerto Plata. And right now we are about 25 years or more living in Puerto Plata, so it's a little bit funny. He put a love in the whole family, not just my parents, also my brothers and me, to work in the missions, to work in the ministry, to open up a church, and not just plant one church, but everywhere we go in the city and the countryside, we will open a church to serve people in need that they need God.
So yeah, we serve with the International Mission Board, the IMB, and we're in Bucharest, Romania. And currently, we serve in logistics, and so I help all of our missionary families in this area, just handle different things like visas and vehicles and housing.
God moved my wife and I to plant the church at Pecan Creek about a year ago. We had a new area developing that was near our house, and it quickly became the fastest growing area in Denton County. And we had always desired to begin a church, and there was a need of a church right here next to us in our community. And so we launched it in the elementary school about a year ago.
About 4 months ago, our family was on a missionary care retreat in Bulgaria, and we got this phone call from our director of spiritual care, and he told us about a baby who was dropped into a pit latrine and had been fished out somehow. He didn't know the details, and so we were far away in another country when he called us and told us this story, and we said, of course, see if you can go and find out more about the baby and see if there's any way that we could bring this child in. And our staff, our social workers, and Boniface, the spiritual care director, went there, and began checking this baby out. And after about 3 weeks of persistence, we got to bring that baby to Nami's village. And we gave him the name David, which means beloved. And this baby has not only survived, but he is beautiful and he's thriving. And now he's almost 4 months old. And that baby's story is emblematic of why we do what we do.
The impact that we've seen over the years, we came a little over 3 years ago and we had hardly anybody there. I mean, 20-something people there and hardly no families, no kids. And now we've seen families come in and begin to grow. One of the families in particular, the Bach family. Mark and Crystal came, they have three girls, and began to see them get involved in the church. And now Mark is one of my volunteer worship leaders, and began to see how now he's come in, got discipled, and now he turns around and making disciples himself.
A couple of people that stand out as really being impacted is Mark and Debbie. They're a couple that have been together for the past 2 years. They came to one of our cookouts earlier this summer, and honestly, they came because they were hungry. They're homeless. They live in a tent, and they really were feeling desperate and hopeless in a lot of ways. And Debbie, she professes to have been a Christian for a long time, but just stepped away from God. But Mark came to the place where he realized he had never trusted God, and actually had the privilege of baptizing both of them. I feel like one reason that we've been able to connect with Mark and Debbie is we've helped meet a lot of practical needs. And they've been homeless for 2 years, and next week they're going to be moving into their apartment, just in a small part based on the ways that we've helped them to take those steps.
So Tom Rainer of Lifeway would tell us that less than 1 out of 7 millennials in our country would call themselves Christians, and that is the most unreached generation in the history of America. And yet the people we've been able to baptize over the last 2.5 years have all been millennials. All of my gospel community leaders and apprentice leaders, millennials. One of my favorite stories is about Jazz and Brianna. Jazz and Brianna came to us when we were still a little Bible study in our basement. Jazz was a refugee who came from Bosnia when he was 6 years old. And the story ends this way. I got to baptize both of them, do their wedding. Now Brianna leads worship, is one of the most phenomenal female vocalists, but it's grown now, not just as a singer, but is leading our church in celebrating the gospel together. Taught Jazz how to play the bass guitar, and week in, week out, he's on the stage playing the bass guitar as well. He's now an apprentice leader in one of our gospel communities, and we get excited about the thought of him leading his own gospel community in the next year. What about planting a church for Bosnian-speaking people? We have 3,000 Bosnians in Sioux Falls. And so these are the kind of things that get our imagination stirring for what God's been doing.
I want to personally thank you, Cottonwood Creek, for having the desire to help another church. We are a church like yours, except extremely small right now and extremely new. But we do the same things that you guys do on a smaller degree. We try to reach our community, and every penny that you give to Cottonwood Creek, part of that is coming back to a church that you will never see, perhaps. Maybe you'll never meet me in person, but you are affecting an area by what you're giving there at Cottonwood Creek. And we just want to thank you. Without partnerships like this, our church would not exist, and these people would not be getting reached right now.
In addition, even to the prayer you guys provide for us, and you know, the words of encouragement that just mean so much, you know, even if you don't know it, Cottonwood supports our ministry and our organization through the cooperative program, just being a Southern Baptist church. And you know, that money goes to support missionaries all over the world. And you know, some of that gets to us. It doesn't have your name on it when we see it in our paycheck, but we are very thankful each and every month that it comes, that we're, you know, our ministry is, you know, really, it's because of the churches back home. It's because of you guys that really allow us to be here and to be sharing the gospel with the people of Romania. So thank you guys so very much for all that you do and all that you give.
Since Cottonwood, Meshach Ministry have been able to reach thousands of people that we haven't the tools to reach. We love to do missions. We love to go to the countryside to preach the gospel, but not just to preach the gospel, to go and share the gospel, not giving the word empty-handed, but able to deliver at least some kind of comfort, rice, beans, seeds, clothing, medical apparatus. So the word of God doesn't go empty, you know? they can see that the God comes with help, you know? And Cottonwood has been able to do, to let us do that.
We don't get to do what we do in Kenya without your support. And Cottonwood Creek has come alongside Naomi's village and then financial support, prayer support. They come and visit. You guys come and see us and visit the kids and pour into the lives of our children and our staff out there. And we just couldn't do it without you. Cottonwood Creek has also come alongside our family just as missionaries. And I mean, we just don't have words enough to say thank you for that.
In the biggest way I know how, thank you for praying for us. We believe it makes a huge difference. Thank you for supporting our families financially, and thank you for participating all for the sake of the gospel. It makes a difference to our church, to my family, and ultimately to the city of Baltimore.